Ready?
Yep.
Okay, so we're out here and we're here with tutorial number 8. Okay, this is one which everyone wants, everyone needs, and it's epic, right? So if I say the name, you should know it's called mousetrap. What it is, it's just simply this. It makes it look like you've lost the ball, okay? You can use it as a beat, as a panna, and you can make some crazy variations. For now, I'm just going to teach you a basic one, okay? The way that I do it, you have to think about why you're doing it. If you want to do it, normally you want to do it to send the opponent, right? Because they think you've missed it, they're going to lunge wherever it looks like you missed the ball. So, for me, I don't see if you're using it for a panna, say I'm the defender, right? You're not going to want to do the mousetrap here, because they're just going to, you know, take it. You have to aim the mousetrap around here, which causes them to lunge, okay? So what I'm going to do is, say you're actually where you'll be, as a defender, I turn my body, as I'm right-footed, I turn my right behind, actually I roll it to my left. What I'm going to do is put my left foot on the ball, and I'm going to roll it out to here, okay? That's where the trick's going to happen. But to do the trick, step one, as I said, we're going to have left foot on the ball. We know where we're aiming it, we're going to aim it out here, which will cause you to step in the gap, right? So the first thing we do is when we roll it slowly, okay? And we follow the ball the whole time, okay? Some people, I see you doing mashups like this, and they're like not really looking, right? That's going to happen. So what we're going to do is, we're going to roll it this way, slowly. It doesn't have to be quick. It's really easy. Obviously, if you want to do it quick later, you do different ones, it's fine. But to start, we're just going to do it slow. So we're going to roll it, put our feet together. Why I say this is so that we do not do this. That's wrong. We don't want that. We want to do it so it goes around the outside. Okay? When we've got that, that's step one. Step two, we're just going to put our weight down on our left foot, okay? And lift up our right. Here is when we've got to make sure we're watching the ball. Because what we're going to do is we're going to go around it, kick the floor, okay? And that's the mousetrap motion. So we go around the ball. When it's here, leave it and get it. So if we do that fluidly, we're saying like this. One, two. And you just got to make sure that you're going around. The way we go around is this way. So it's like that's the way. You can't really go around it another way. When you make sure that your leg's obviously going behind your other leg, and you get it. So this motion you just practice. So you just do one, roll it back, two, and so on, right? And that could really help. But then to do the panna. So say you're doing the panna, you're gonna roll it. That's by this point when we've missed it. That's when they should. So when we're here, we're still going. That's when they'll step. So then when you get here to get the panna, you're actually gonna roll it back. So that's essentially the mousetrap, but you can do crazy variations, right? So if you look at someone called Zohe, he's always doing crazy ones. My ankle's still not great, so I'm not really going to drop much, but you can just make sure that you're like doing it from different positions and like learning it, like different feet and such, and you can do something crazy. So look, I want you to get it down. Firstly, any questions, just DM me, I should reply. Hashtag streetpanna when you get it, and I really want to see some nutmegs of it. So yeah, send it to me, and that's it. We out.